Hello friends, welcome to Power Electronic lecture series. Today we will see the information related to the modes of operation of TRIAC and its advantages, disadvantages and application of it. Let us see what are the different modes of operation of TRIAC and its working. Let us see modes of operation of TRIAC. Okay, now here is the structure of TRIAC is drawn. This is MT1 terminal, this is MT2 terminal and this is gate terminal. Okay, now in mode 1, what happens in mode 1? In mode 1 of TRIAC, MT2 terminal is positive and gate terminal is positive. So, we are connecting MT2 terminal to the positive terminal of battery and the gate is connected to positive. So the positive battery supply is connected to gate and negative battery supply is connected to the MT1 terminal. Okay, as this is negative and this is positive, the direction of flow of gate current is towards this side. The direction of gate current is towards this side. Okay, as MT2 is positive with respect to MT1, this P1N1 junction, this junction is forward bias. Okay, and this MT1 terminal is connected to negative terminal, so this N1-P2 junction is reverse bias. Now, as MT1 is connected to negative terminal, the charge carriers are injected from P2 to N3. The charge carriers are injected from the P2 semiconductor layer to the N3 semiconductor layer. So, the current is flowing like this: P1, N1, P2 and N3. So, this is what? Direction of current. So the current is flowing from the current direction is from P1 N1 and P2 N3. So this is what first mode of operation, where MT2 is positive, MT1 is negative and gate is positive. So this gate is connected to positive battery supply, MT1 is connected to negative battery supply. As the current is flowing from negative to positive, so this is what direction of gate current. Now as MT2 is positive, so this junction is P1 N1 junction is forward bias. Okay, and MT1 is negative, MT1 is connected to negative terminal of battery, so this P2 N1 junction is reverse bias. And the charge carriers are injected from the P2 layer to the N3 layer. So the direction of flow of current is from MT2 to MT1. So it is flowing through the semiconductor layer as P1, N1, P2 and N3. So this is what first mode of operation. Now let us see the second mode of operation. In mode 2, the MT2 is positive, MT2 is positive and the gate terminal is negative here. Okay, as in previous mode, we connected positive battery supply to the gate. Now gate is negative, so we are connecting the negative battery supply to the gate. Okay, so as MT2 is positive and the gate is connected to the negative terminal of battery. So the direction of gate current is now in this direction. The gate is in this direction. Same, MT2 is positive. So this junction is P1 N1 junction is forward bias. The junction formed between P2 and N1 is reverse bias. And now the charge carriers are injected into the N2 semiconductor layer. Okay. So the direction of flow of current is from P1, N1, P2 and N2. So the current direction here is the current direction is P1 N1, P2 N2. Okay, this is mode 2 of operation. As mode 1 of operation is, it is operated in first quadrant, and mode 2 it operates in second quadrant. Now this is what the case when MT2 terminal is positive. Now let us say in mode 3, what happens? In mode 3, the MT2 terminal is negative. And the gate is negative. Now the MT2 terminal is connected to what? Negative terminal of battery, and gate is connected to negative terminal of battery. So the direction of gate current is like this here. Okay, as MT2 is negative, this junction is reverse biased. Okay, and the MT1 is connected to positive terminal of battery, so the junction formed between P2 and N1, it is forward bias here, and the current carriers are injected from P2 to N2 here because gate is negative. So the direction of flow of current for this type of semiconductor is opposite. It is from MT1, P2, N1, P1, N4. Okay. So the current direction is through. So the current direction is from P2, N1, P1, N4. And this mode of operation, the characteristic is seen in third quadrant. Last mode of operation is mode 4. Okay, mode 4. Here the MT2 is negative and the gate terminal is positive. So the gate is connected to positive terminal of battery, MT1 is connected to negative, and MT2 is again connected to negative. Same as previous, the P1 N1 junction is reverse bias, the P2 N1 junction is forward bias, and the charge carriers are now injected in N3 layer, and the direction of flow of current is from P2 N1 P1 N4. So the current is in opposite direction. The current direction is P2, N1, P1 and N4. And this mode of operation is seen in the characteristic in fourth quadrant. So these are what? Four different modes of operation of TRIAC. Now let us see what are the advantages of TRIAC. Very first advantage is it is a bi-directional device. Means current is flowing in both the direction. Okay. Now we can turn on the TRIAC. We can turn on this device. Turn on the TRIAC using positive gate voltage or negative gate voltage. So negative gate current. We can turn this device with positive gate current or negative gate current. Okay. Third, it is more economical than SCR. Because at the cost of 1 SCR, we can purchase the 2 anti-parallel SCR in TRIAC. It is more suitable for resistive load. Next, there is no need of protection diode in TRIAC. No need of use of protection diode. And we can use only single one heat sink here. We can use only one heat sink here. What is heat sink? These are nothing but protective covering of a device. Now next we'll see the disadvantages of it. What are its disadvantages? We can't use TRIAC as a controlled rectifier. Then it has low dV by dt rating. So because of low dV by dt rating, it accidental turn on of TRIAC is possible. Then it has low di by dt triggering rating. Then its power rating is less than SCR. Power rating is less than SCR. And triggering circuit for the TRIAC, the triggering circuit need to be designed carefully. In last lecture we had seen the application of TRIAC. So let us write down some specification of TRIAC here. Now the proper TRIAC has rating of 1200 volt and 300 ampere. It has highest switching frequency of 400 hertz. Its highest switching frequency is 400 hertz. Its switching time is 200 to 400 microsecond, and it is bidirectional device. Okay, as we had seen in today's lecture, the different modes of operation of TRIAC, then how it works in mode 1 and mode 2, mode 3 and mode 4. Then we had seen the advantages of TRIAC, some disadvantages of TRIAC and specification of TRIAC. Now let us revise again. What are the applications of TRIAC? We can use TRIAC in fan regulators. Okay, we can use the TRIAC in lamp dimmer. The TRIAC can be used in temperature controllers. It can be used in flasher circuits. Okay, so that is all for today's session. So thank you for watching this video, and that is all for today's session. In today's session we had seen various modes of operation of TRIAC, then its advantages, disadvantages, specification and application of it. Thank you for watching this video, and if you are having any queries, please write down your queries in comment so that I can clarify in the next session. Thank you.